People ask me, how do you get your bench from 320 pipe to 360 pipe in 3 months? I'm gonna share a little bit of technique that I use in this video. So, when you only warm up with just a bar, you gotta treat it like it's your one rep max. Everything that you're gonna use for your one rep max, you gotta do it in a warm up. Leg drive, tight core, tuck your elbows, flex your lats, pass the speed, all of that has to happen in your warm up. That was a typical powerlifting type setup. People asking me, why do I arch my back? That's because that is a powerlifting style setup, huh? This way you could bench long term. Who doesn't want to bench long term? Workout is a long term thing. When you do bodybuilding style, your elbows flared out, you have a flat back, that's how you're gonna get a bunch of shoulder injury, and that's only to focus on the chest. Powerlifting bench is the way to go, whether you're a bodybuilder or not, okay? Trust me, that's the way to go. And I don't like to take a big jump. If you see, I always do quarter or play, and I always prime my nervous system. What I just did right here is to do a lat check, because lats are highly important when it comes to benching. So I flex my lats, make sure they're awake, they're there. And this is my first working set of a 315. So I flex my lats, keep my elbows tight, pop it up. The first rep wasn't that good, but the second rep is a pester. Then the third rep is a little bit smoother too. My second set, 330 pie right here. So, you know, people ask, why do you always do accent? That's because I'm an actor, comedian, and a powerlifter, okay? So I like to have a pun when I make my video. If you don't want to listen to this character bullshit, then you know what? You can go learn some shit on Omar Aesop, Johnny Candido. But here, we're going to learn some shit, and we're going to have some pun. And plus, you're really going to hurt my feeling, huh? Because I really enjoy, like, do comedy, and I enjoy workout. Why can't I do something with both? They really hurt my feeling. Anyway, this is my top set of a 340 pipe. I was gonna go for a max tripper, but you see right here, the first one, it was okay, and then the second one, it slowed down a lot. I probably should have racked away, but for some reason I feel like I could do it. And then guess what, Sarah was a really good spotter. He didn't grab the bar, he just kept waiting and waiting. He was right there waiting to save my life, but he didn't grab until I said, hey, spot. Then I moved on to some slingshot overload work because I was really tired. Like the prior day, I didn't eat that much, didn't sleep that much. So I was like, you know what? I want to keep the working set heavy, put on the slingshot, do some more reps of 335, 355. And that's the way to go, to keep doing some shit. You know, that's why you have all these tools in the gym. It's up to you how you want to use it, huh? And then after this, I did a little bit of pause work. So pause is really important because everybody lockout is strong. Like, who the hell can lockout a 2-inch from the top? But your lockout is useless if out of the bottom you're weak. So it's really important to practice all the pause work at the bottom, so your bottom end is really strong. And also, it's really important to breathe into the bar, because as the weight gets heavy, you don't want the bar to sink lower and lower and increase the range of motion. So you want to breathe into the bar. And also, the tank top that I'm wearing in this video, you can get it at barbellbrigade.com. Okay, see you until next time. Peace.
Today's workout was very tiring. I guess all workouts are tiring. If you're not tired, you're doing that wrong. Today is all deadlift, and it's only deadlift.